all I really want to say is thank you. Because this has had, this has taken a good 2 years and a lot of perseveration. The kits are truly amazing and will give us clinicians who bumble and panic when it's a child and look a bit worried and think, oh, we've got to make a referral to someone because we're not clever enough. Real tools where we can actually just sit down on the floor and go, have a look at this box, Mum and Dad. Have a look at this box. This will help you. Because I think clinicians, no matter how skilled we are, get really scared when it's children and get really scared of saying the wrong thing and doing the wrong thing. And then we refer to social workers and goodness is all anybody we can refer to but us, really, I think is the answer. And you know, actually in practice, that what really makes kids think is it's something you can't talk about because that professional just won't answer the questions. So having tools to explain it, and as one of my CNSs who's very experienced just said, she loved the way that we explained what a hospice is. Just in that really simple language, because sometimes we can get really hung up with our technical language. So my bit's really simple. Thank you, this is such an amazing resource, and I just know the clinicians will love it. Thank you both.
Telling them to sit there and be quiet and don't disturb the person in that bed because they weren't very well, and it had a real impact on them because they were still kids who wanted to go to Brownies and who wanted to go and play football and who wanted to do the things that the kids still had to do. They still had to do their homework, and when I started working with Gemma in the hospice, it was kind of like, what can we do to support children who are going through probably the worst thing that will ever happen to them at that age, certainly. And it's kind of like, yeah, and then we met Jodie, who says, I've got this idea, I've got these things. It's like, yeah, we can make that happen. And every single time I've seen something in these boxes, I've cried every single time, because there's a line in the passport, it's like, what can I do? And one of the things in there it says is, well, you could rub your favourite hand cream into their hands. And I did that with my mum when she was dying of cancer. And it really actually, you know, every time I read it, it punches me in the gut and just gives me the kind of drive to keep going out to people saying, give me some money because we're doing this thing with these cool people. And I'm really glad that as an East London charity, we could work with Jodie and with Gemma, with, you know, supporting the child bereavement team, supporting the end of life ward upstairs, making sure that the refurbishment has the stuff that it needs to make it a little bit nicer. I slept on the floor next to my mum for a week when she was dying. And one of the things Gemma says is, we'd quite like to get some fold out beds. And it's like, okay, we'll get them because I know what that was like. So I'm really glad that we've been able to fund these, and I really hope they make a difference to your lives and to the lives of the little kids that, you know, are going to start getting their first boxes in the next day or two. Thank you very much, and thank you, Sam, for coming up with Snorky.
So similarly, I had experience, so I lost my dad when I was 13 with cancer, and we didn't talk about it or have any kind of communication within the family. And we moved to Devon, which made it easier to not talk about it. And that was a really good coping mechanism until I was about 30. And then suddenly had my own kids, and it was just like that, oh, kind of that prolonged grief started to crack out. So I kind of saw that we do other kits for families, to help families where the parent has cancer. And kind of I can understand that impact and not talking about it and how detrimental it is to even as an adult. So, with help of Rose's mummy and Jodie and I, we developed some bespoke tools for St. Joe's Hospice and some ones that we kind of had fluffing about. So, would you like me to just briefly go through what's inside? Okay, they're sort of broadly in four categories. There's educational, communication, practical tools, and tools that help with emotions. So, with the education side, there's a parent's guide, which lists things that they might find in their boxes. And it gives a guide to sort of, it's not prescriptive, but it's kind of an advice on maybe to use up this or like that. And then it's also got additional information that might help them understand what their children are going through. So what to expect behaviorally, or if there's changes in how they respond to things, that this is all normal, this is okay. And then we've got the body map, and that just shows you in a sort of very creative, artistic way where things in are the body. And that's quite useful for adults as well as children, and clinicians sometimes, I think. And also we have paper chase people, so they are going to try to come. How many did we have? 20 or something like that? Roles, people that work in the hospice, and a very short summary of what they did. And this is obviously so the children can understand who in the team are caring for their loved one and what they do. And then we've got the communication stuff is there's practical ones like school letters, so again the parents don't have to think of that additional task, and the schools are linked in and they understand what's going on at home. What am I good at? And these are sort of building self-confidence. Often children lose their sense of sort of, or their role within the family when it's very chaotic, and they can often get ignored or shouted at or whatever when it's very stressful time. So what am I good at is a way of opening dialogue between the adults and the children to say, hey, you're really good at telling jokes, or you're really good at walking the dog. And again, it's a way of boosting their kind of self-esteem. And then the practical stuff, there's a daily timetable, because young kids and old kids kind of like to know what's going on throughout the day. So with the young kids, there's a daily timetable split up. So you've got the morning, afternoon, and evening, and they know where they are, whether they're at school, grandma's picking them up, whether they're going to the hospice, blah, blah, blah. And they're on magnets, so they can look onto the fridge or whatever, and they can understand what's going on. And for the older ones, it's monthly ones, and again, it's stickers that they can put on, and they can write on their own bits and pieces. And then emotionally, there's how can I help as well, because often children do feel excluded when things are quite stressful. So we've got a way of them to start a dialogue saying, how can I help around the house? So it's things like emptying the bin, vacuuming, and all those kind of things. And then emotionally, there's the worry boxes, which is a tried and tested method, really, isn't it? And so they can create their own worry boxes, either put, draw, or write their worries in, and maybe just a way of parking it for the moment, or perhaps asking the parent to go through with it every week to see what are problems. Similarly with the worry chatterbox, which you could do yourself there. And then we've got the keep calm kits, just different ways that children can try to start to sort of manage their own emotions. And so things like counting, imagining a special place, or balancing poses, being creative and active, and those sort of things. There's the jolly big people, which come with, they can come with this. And this again is sort of them understanding the roles that, or the people that they receive who look after their loved ones, who they are. So we colour coded them in, but they're meant to represent who looks after the person in the hospice. And then we've got My Paper Chain, which they can create their own people. So again, they understand who looks after their loved one, but actually who looks after them, you know, where are they in the world, where, you know, it might be not just be sort of their parents, it might be, you know, Owen's mum, might be a teacher, a scouts leader, or something like that. So for them to get an understanding of actually who's supporting them in the staff. And then lastly are the hospice passports. And this sort of encompasses all the practical, emotional, communication stuff. And it basically tells them what a hospice is in comparison to a hospital. And what they can do, and that's really important, isn't it? So again, don't shush. You know, you can use the gardens, and you can laugh, and you can do things. And some other bits and pieces that will help the time go easier for them. And then that was it, I think.
Brilliant.
So yes, thank you Jodie for helping me create all the bits and pieces, and there's a big team of us, well not big, but there's a small team of us, so a great graphic designer and an illustrator who helped as well, so thank you.
And we've got some live music at 4 o'clock as well, so come down later on, drink more
pins.
Thank you. Okay, thank you very much. Add lemonade to the bins, don't have it neat like